This is the place to go for anime, manga, comics, video games, all pop culture information. This is the place that you need to be. This program is brought to you by Blacken Studios Entertainment Division. Remember, it's Blacken.
This is Haley Cummings, and when I want to listen to something funny and down to earth, I tune into the hardest working podcast out there. My favorite and Oklahoma's favorite podcast, The Elijah Bailey Show.
Nigga, what's up, your Brad? It's more like Dodo.
Grown ass man. Oh. But baby shit, Brad.
Oh, yo, nigga, your Brad. Woo! Onions?
Overly aggressive.
Onions. Ah, oh, nigga, your shit smell like like, you know how they talk about, like, we have black holes and shit to lead to other dimensions. Like, you must be having, like, doo-doo from other dimension. Like, if we met an alien came down and shit, that's what your breath smells like right now.
And they wouldn't be hitting you. You just don't be expecting it either. So it's just, it's like a slow drift to your nose. It's not even like a fast, like chi attack. It's like a...
That shit.
Bitch!
I feel like that's what Jerome's breath smelled like before he had Jerome, hanging out, Jerome, what you do? But folks, we are here in 3, 2, 1. We are here for the Elijah Bailey Show. This is episode 295. Talking about some shit. Literally. Yes. Like, if there was...
Brush your teeth, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, dude. Yeah, you got your hygiene, motherfucker.
You don't want to do it for yourself.
Do it for others.
Do it for the others. Please.
Please.
Do it for others.
Please. Hey, we don't want to smell doo-doo breath, baby. But we're
ain't
here.
Ain't trying to smell it.
Not at all. Thank you guys for waiting. I know you're like, where were you guys on Saturday? Work was bullshit.
Yeah, that's right. We did miss that. Yeah, and, I was out.
Yeah, I know you were, because I was hitting you up with stuff. Like, I was like, hey, I'm just now heading home, like, at 7:30.
I was I'm just now seeing the back of my eyelids.
And my modem was out, so I had to order a new one.
Wait, let me go and call it out real quick. Stone didn't say shit.
Yeah, Stone didn't even hit us. So we were like, hey, we're playing tomorrow? Like, I feel like them ass whooping was like, I don't want to play anymore. Yeah,
it's starting to get to him.
Hey, he acting like Cher, like, no more. I don't want to play. I just want to love. Hey, he's stretching them auras out.
Yeah, that's what that is.
Aura, we are playing tomorrow?
Yeah, Stone, if you watching this, then yeah, you hear me. I'm blatantly disrespectfully talking about your ass.
But found his stride. After,
finally.
Like, there's just, like, the anger that comes with, like, the amount of W's you take, and you're like, I'm not gonna take it anymore. He's that old 1950s white man that you couldn't blatantly disrespect him in public. Like, it's like, you're not gonna ask me if I need a napkin. Like,
nope, I'm on your ass now.
Where is this fucking white rage coming from? But this is the Elijah Bailey Show. Thank you guys for tuning in and joining us. This is the place where we believe that without Jolene, a lot of people might not have gotten into JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, and that this year, 2021, and the COVID lockdown quarantines have proven to give anime the boost that it needs in this time frame to capture more eyes, because we've had major deals and this is the time to live in. We are here for the 295th episode of the Elijah Bailey Show. This is our anime awards episode. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to cover these news articles in depth in another stream, because like I was saying at the top of the show, my modem went out, so I wasn't able to stream. My connection was janky. If you guys tuned in for we had a stream where we were playing Naruto Shippuden. This is the last time that we were actually playing, and
yeah, 11th.
Exactly. And like within the first couple of, you know, minutes that we were up, we had like 100-something views, and people were, we had a nice chat. So thank all of our followers that joined during that stream, everybody that was chatting. You guys can always come back. Since then, I haven't really been able to stream. So when I do stream, I'm going to go over these topics in more depth with you, because we are going to focus on the actual anime titles from 2021 that are comprised in each one of our categories for the Anime Awards. But these are the latest news articles that we will go over in another stream. Tokyo Revenger gets a new anime adaptation for the epic Christmas Showdown arc, where the death of somebody's brother would have led Tomen into a spiral later on into the future. Amazing arc. That was one where you were like, what the fuck is Takemichi going to do? Because he still ain't in the gym. He don't never go to the gym no matter what he has to do.
Never
going
to the gym, boy.
Chainsaw Man anime premieres 2022, and the second part launches on Shonen Jump Plus in the summer of 2022. And this is something I was waiting for ever since I finished the last chapter of Chainsaw Man, because I feel like the story was unfinished and it just now opened its world up. The Bleach Thousand Year Blood War arc anime, they revealed a new trailer, and when it premieres October 2022, that looks really good. I really loved that arc because you got to find out more about Ichigo's parents, his backstory, and then like basically, are these motherfuckers living in the Matrix? Dragon Ball Super Superhero Gohan is back. The Gohan from the tournament, the manga saga that double KO'd Kefla, is back. We see him fighting. We got confirmation that him and Piccolo both are fighting Gamma 1 and Gamma 2, which are confirmed to be new androids from the Red Ribbon Army. But Gohan is in the classic Piccolo with the black wristbands on, with the shoulder pads going Super Saiyan 2 again, taking the glasses off like Clark motherfucking Clint. Or he had some smelling breath hit his eyes. He says, I gotta get it off here before these glasses disintegrate. I'll also be talking about the two Naruto novels that get a manga adaptation in 2022, and the Fullmetal Alchemist mobile video game showed its first trailer, and I was like, damn, this is as good as the PlayStation games that I played, you know, just updated to 2021, 2022. And Overlord has a anime trailer for its season 4 for 2022. So we will cover that in another stream. Yeah, it is about time. And that shit looks good, too. Mm-hmm. There's so much good stuff. But typically, when you join the show, we have three segments. We have segment one, where we cover the releases for this month, or we go back into the body shop for the Bailey Bugle. Segment two is going to be our main topic, plus Taiyosei, the black character that we honor for the episode. And then segment three is our anime and manga of the month. Today's show, we're just going to dive right into the anime awards, because there's a lot of categories that we have and a lot of anime we're going to talk about. And then we will take a break, and we'll round out the show with the last segment, which is traditionally segment three, the anime and manga of the month. But before we do that, because we just now started the show, we're 13 minutes in. How you been doing, Buck?
Doing all right, man. Doing all right.
Can't
complain too much.
Did you put the Akatsuki hoodie on after I sent you them shoes?
This is Sasuke.
Hey, if you're not yelling Sasuke's name, what are you doing?
What are you doing with your life? You know what I'm saying? Like, what are you? You're missing out, and you don't even realize it.
Dude, Are you excited about this holiday season? Like, the days that we're getting off. Those are your days that you work.
Yeah, those are the days I work. So it's definitely. Feels great to have them off. Yeah, me and the wife plan on definitely trying to redo the living room.
All I want to do is zoom, zoom, zoom. Oh, okay. Redo the living room. Okay.
Redo the living room. Yeah.
Hey, put that couch over. Put your ass up on the couch over there. Yeah. Boys, don't come out of your room for 2 to 3 hours.
Yeah, I just sent you a picture of something I did this past weekend. So this little thing goes like right behind the couch. Like, our couch is butt up against the wall.
Yeah.
So this is like a little shelf that floats right on top of the back part of the couch to try to, we got some plug-ins on it. And you can also put your drink or whatever else up there.
Oh, okay. So, there we go. Ooh.
Yeah, and that's the theme, is that blue, gold, and white. So
that'd be nice.
Yeah.
That's kind of like the trim in this room. Like, I'm about to change it up, because the way that they did it before is just like, they just got a nice size, probably about an inch and a half to 2 inch. Probably about an inch and a half. just like wood slats and put them up. We're going to get some trim that's a little bit nicer, a little bit cleaner, the smaller trim, mm-hmm. and still keep it that dark navy blue and trim the room. Because removing these thicker borders, I feel like if you recede it in a little bit, it'll just make it look like the room's a little bit bigger than what it is. And I think it'll match like the new couch and stuff we're going to get in here. So those will be the next things.
Dope. Dude. But other than that, I think everything's been doing all right. I've been playing some Halo, watching some anime, got back on, finished, what's the name again? Shaman King.
Ooh,
that was hella good. Hate that, you know, it's there's another part that's coming out. Can't wait for that. Been watching JoJo, of course. Loving that. Of course, finished it, actually.
And this is Stone Ocean?
Stone Ocean.
Yeah.
I had to tip the hat to that. Started a one call...
Why are you thinking of that? Shout out to Isan for liking the stream. Thank you for jumping in. Isan. Correct me if I'm wrong. Thank you. But keep going. What you?
Can't remember. I can't remember what I watched it on, to be honest with you. Now I'm thinking about
remember.
It. Sales at Work.
The second one? The black one?
Yeah, the black, Code Black. That's what it's called. Yeah. I never watched it. So,
are you watching on Netflix or are you watching it on the Crunchy?
Crunchy.
Okay.
Yeah. So I got the, I think I'm on episode 2 of that. So I'm pretty excited about that because, you know.
Yeah, it was a very good show.
It was pretty legit.
I think it was much needed in the COVID era. You know, how the body works, like why it's
very
good to stay clean.
Very educational. But so if you haven't watched that, I definitely recommend it to you.
I didn't get to ask you because we had a super long chapter for Dragon Ball Super, which we're going to have to dive into. Did you read it?
Did it drop?
Okay. You know when...
Did Black Clover drop yesterday?
You're behind on both of them. Okay. See, this is why we didn't cover them today, folks. This is an anime episode. And this is what we're going to do before we take our first pause for the cause. Yeah, this latest chapter. I compare this chapter.
Was it good? It must not have been that good because you didn't. I mean, no, of course it was good.
I just been sleeping. Oh, yeah. They like, you know how the last couple chapters been feeling short for Super? They've been long. This one was long. Clover was still
45 pages. That is a lengthy.
Black Clover.
See, Clover was just a quick 15.
But the 15 that it gave you like wraps up everything that we've been asking about. Like, where are these motherfuckers at? Who is this? Asta's about to get back in it.
He's in full Dell mode again.
Yeah, he nutted once and he had to let me get my OJ and he came back in there like Vin Reams on Baby Boy. Like, I got my knee pads on, Devil.
And I see Yuno just pop back up to the same toe.
Yeah. Yuno's like, I've got wood. He came back. He's like, this is my kingdom. I'm an anime character. So, yeah, they was real good. I was surprised you didn't hit me because I was worried about my modem. And that's why I didn't say nothing. But I was like, oh, man, Black Clover's good. Jujutsu Kaisen was good. One Piece was good. I was like, oh, yeah, okay, here comes Super. And I was like, the episode of Super... Or this chapter is comparatively when Naruto came back 2 years later after the time skip with the new threads and it was more black. Granola? Did you go to the
Granola
academy?
Come back with the hits. Granola come back with
hey,
the
work. Hey, but I'm not going to lie. Like, gas and oil and gas is...
gas ain't no fun, bitch.
Hey, he's got the green and the yellow lantern rings. This motherfucker, he is doing the shit up.
Them rings.
It's nice. It's really, really good. And then to see Vegeta as King Vegeta kind of coming in and the shit that he says makes this really fucking good. I really enjoyed it. So, yeah, you got to watch those, dude. You got to read them. And again, they're good reads, but we are digressing. You can go ahead and keep looking at those pages real quick cuz we're going to take a quick.
You know that's what I'm doing.
Oh, God, what are they doing? Whose wish is this? Yeah. So we're going to take a quick pause for the cause. And again, during the show, if you guys have noticed, if you watch the show live here on twitch.tv/Elijah_5000, you're getting Rifty Beats for commercials, intro, outro. But if you listen to the show when it drops every Thursday, the reason the show just dropped today is because my modem, I couldn't connect to fucking edit the show. You're getting the official commercials for the show. And you've noticed that there's a batch of new anime-inspired theme commercials coming in. So you guys can hear that, listen to that during the breaks if you are listening post-show. So the show's at 4:30 on Sundays, Central Standard Time, twitch.tv/Elijah_5000, or on Facebook, Edge B Gaming, EJ B Gaming. And every Thursday, every Thursday the show drops anywhere that you listen to podcasts, especially if you're listening to them on anime podcast forums, Podcoin. Hey, granola. Hey, I'm just going to say.
No, I didn't do that one. I just knocked out Black Clover real quick.
No, I know you hit that one, but okay. granola fingering people. That's all I'm going to tell you.
He fingering people too?
Hey.
He ain't fingering like Lucifer fingering people. That motherfucker came on the scene like.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No, he's more like the first Ryakage.
Hey.
He coming in. Nasty. But like just I said, Gas said, take the G off and put an extra S on the end, because that's what I'm coming for. Coming for your ass. Okay. He has been, even without the wish, I feel like that motherfucker was in, he's in Vegeta training mode, and there's something about their species that helps him out. But I digress. We've been taking too long. Let's take this pause for the cause. Number one, and we'll come back with our predictions, what we voted on as anime for each one of these categories of the year for 2021 for our anime awards. Thank you guys for joining us so much. We'll be right back after this commercial break. Listen to the Attack on Titan Scouts theme, I do believe, from the man himself, Rifty Beats. We'll be right back. Summer is here. Bright days full of great weather, beautifully satisfying breezes, and a glimmer of hope on the horizon. But summer is also the perfect time for revenge. That's right. Whether it be by handshake, magic summoning, or just the afterlife for otakus, we'll help you get what you so crave. Simply call us at 1-900-738-3643 and schedule your consultation today.
Looking for your voice to be heard? Have a passion and want to share it with those of a common mindset? Have a business or a brand that needs to get the word out but don't know where to advertise? Contact Blacken Studios, a full-spectrum, cutting-edge podcast studio that services clients from all over the country. Blacken Studios offers you more than just a podcast. We offer you an experience. In-house production from audio-video recording, editing, marketing, advertisement, and exposure with over thousands of people listening weekly. Blacken Studios doesn't hesitate to back local businesses. So when you want your voice heard, Blacken Studios has your back. Search Blacken Studios on all social platforms. Email at podcast@blackenstudios.com or visit us at blackenstudios.com. And remember, it's Blacken.
And what is up, folks? We are back. The Bucky had to run to the car real quick. He had to go to the car quickly, so we're going to keep things pushing, keep things moving as we go into the Anime Awards. Now, we have several categories. I'm going to read them all to you, and we will give you our answers for these categories. We have a total of 15 categories for anime selections for this year's 2021 Anime Awards. We have the Best Husbando, Best Waifu, Best Fight Scene, Best Opener, and this is just like Best Opening Music, Best Closing Music, Best Narrative, Best Animation, Best Manga of the Year. Well, actually, we'll move Anime and Manga of the Year to the very end. It'll be Best Protagonist, Best Antagonist, Best Opening Overall Scene, Best Ending Scene, Best Overall Score, Best Couple, then we have Best Manga of the Year and Anime of the Year. Those are our 15 categories for this year's Anime Awards. And we are not giving you a Talia Say character. Last week's episode was Knuckles, the Echidna. And I showed Jessica the trailer this morning. I thought she saw the Sonic 2 trailer. She was like, what the fuck? I was like, yeah, this is coming in. It was nice all the way up until Knuckles, and then when you see Knuckles, you're like, oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, it's just... It gets stupid good. It's crazy.
So now the Buckety is back. Let's go ahead and start diving into these categories.
I'm having some weird internet issues over here, but keep going.
We'll dive into the awards and give our answers for best category for best husbando. Yes. So let's just dive right down the list. Best husbando. If you have not seen The Way of the House Husband, it basically follows Tatsu, the immortal dragon, former Yakuza, it's like destroyer. He's like fearless, if you guys understand what that name means. And you know what? For Cowboy Bebop, they had recorded like a good number of episodes for season two already before it got canceled. So now I'm kind of...
Are they going to tease it or something?
I don't know. I hope so. I want to see it.
Yeah.
But yeah, he is a former Yakuza that fell in love and only wants to do the best things for his wife. So why would he not be best husbando for the year of 2021? I don't know, but that's who I give it to. Who's your
pick? That's pretty clutch, man. I'm trying to think off the top of my head. Because I share the shit out that anime. I share the shit out of that anime to people. I tell people, hey, like a few people, like, hey, man, my wife makes more money than me. How should I feel about that? I'm like, then that means you have graduated, my boy.
Yeah.
To the house husband.
Yes, you have made it.
Watch this. You have made it made it to the promised land. There we go. I think the internet's looking a little bit
better, crisper.
Yeah. Let me try to change one more thing. It's real quick. Okay. But yeah, I mean that. That's just a dope ass anime.
Yeah, it's very fun. And you know what? Like, I'm gonna say this, like, just off the top, like it made me feel like he is black. Not gonna lie, like he's going down the street, cops messing with him, like, what are you doing here, boy? I'm just trying to bring my wife lunch. You look suspicious. Like, bring my wife lunch, but you look suspicious. Leave me alone
for no reason.
Yeah, I was trying to pull up a trailer, but I'm running out of monitor space. If you want to help me with that, if you want to help me with the second tower for the show and the streams, you can always contribute by going to the Patreon, to the PayPal. Yeah, and that'll help continue to help the show thrive and us be alive here at the studio. So who is your pick? Did you want to double down on Tatsu?
No, wait, let me ask you this. What are the recommendations for
what's like the outlier or what's the guidelines for it?
What's the requirement?
Like best husband, like who would you want to be the husband?
They
like,
have to be an active husband.
Or traits. They have best husbando traits, like who's caring, considerate, takes care of the family if there is one.
I gotta
one.
Give it to my boy Yami.
Okay.
I think Yami you have to look through it, but deep down inside, he shows some real ride or die husband traits. He's always at home. He ain't out kicking it all the time. You know, he's always leaving the toilet, you know, clean. Seat down, clean.
booty
he
up.
Always got your back, booty up. He always got your back. You see, he can raise kids just fine. And the way that he treats Charlotte and the other females are part of the captains. He's a gentleman. Now he's a little rough on the edges.
Around the edges, you know, yeah.
It's because he's out doing work. He's a blue collar worker. There you go.
That is true. Okay, so Yami from Black Clover. I'm down with that. I can see it. And then the manga just further goes into that relationship. So yeah, I can get down with that. So best husbando, Tatsu from the Way of the House Husband, and Yami from Black Clover. Next category, best waifu. I have Nagisa Minase from Girlfriend. She is the second girlfriend, so the second girl introduced to the show. And for her, she takes time off of school to learn how to be a better girlfriend for our main character, or the leader of the harem that really is doubling up, tripling up on girlfriends. And she's the one that joins them because... in earnest, her hard work really captured his heart, that she would drop out of school to make sure that she's the best version of herself. So she gets in shape, She makes sure she learns how to clean, cook. Yeah. Like, what things do I not have? And we talked about this a couple of days ago, how a woman at 32 realized that she didn't have nothing to offer when asked, like, you know, yeah, I'm giving up my time and stuff for you, but what would I benefit by dating you? And she was like, I didn't realize that I had no other skills. Yeah, so.
I have no idea, my boy.
So why I said I like the show, because it addresses issues that you don't normally, that don't normally get addressed. And so now, with her actually giving up her time and herself to be a better version of herself for somebody that she wants to care for, I think that is best waifu material. What about you?
Can't knock it. Who you calling? I would have to go with, I had to think really hard about it. And I hope I'm pronouncing her name right. I think her name is Shion.
Shion.
From the time I got reincarnated as a slime.
Okay, okay.
She's the one that has the, she has like purple hair. She and the has horn. The unicorn. Yeah, yeah. She had one like of the ogres. Horn. Yeah, one of the ogres. No, not the ogres. Not the orcs. She's one of the. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, she's the first friend in the orcs. Because the orcs, like, they're more pigs.
Yeah. She always have like the, like a purple suit on. Later on in the series, she actually ends up dying, and then Lord Tempest had to revive her back. But I pick her because even though she's not the strongest amongst everybody, she's always down to throw hands.
Always.
She's She's always holding her boo thing close.
She is.
To her bosom. She's always making sure, hey, I'm going to do this for you. I got you here. I'm going to go run and handle these people for you, my lord.
I should have known. The man that loves titty milk, I should have known. That would have been a contributing factor to this this waifu selection.
Yeah, so I think I'm going to have to go with her.
Okay, I'm down with that. That's a fair.
I should try to throw some pictures at your boy. Keep going.
Yeah, those are fair picks. So Nagisa Minase from Girlfriend, Girlfriend, and then Shion from That Time I Got Reincarnated as Slime. Now, this one had me, like, my pick for anime, because we did our anime awards, is different than this one, because I had to go back and check.
You had to go back and look at them books, huh?
And it's
looking back at them books, and you was like, ooh!
Like, there was a couple that I might have had, I could have put up against this one from One Piece. But I was like, overall, when this actually came out, I remember how hype it was. I remember the clips. I remember, like, everything that they did, the money they put into this scene. So my best fight scene of the year had to shift over to Black Clover. It is Asta and Yami versus Dante before, like, the very final episode of the series. But the fights continue to get better from there in the manga. But that is my fight scene of the year. And that shit right there, that was.
That shit was cold. And like you said earlier, man, that's the same one that I picked out for a little bit of anime when we did this. Just because that fight scene was just so
epic.
This is the thing, because I actually did the same thing you did. I went and watched the Whitebeard Pirates and Roger Pirates fight. Which I ain't never seen that. That was epic as fuck. So there were some strong contenders for this class, because that was strong. I went and saw what was the other one? Seven Deadly Sins. Escanor and what's the name fought this year? They fought at the beginning of this year. The dude with the silver hair, the other Ten Commandments, which was,
it was
legit
actually
fight.
Michael, but he went as Zeldris, but the third
Zeldris. No, not Zeldris.
No, he was the third brother, but he was essentially Michael. He was the actual vessel of Michael that Escanor had taken.
I watched
his light,
that fight because Escanor just rocking up, just, you know, Escanor, my boy. He just walks up and said, I did not allow you to end this fight, my boy. That was another dope fight. There was another the one off Jujutsu Kaisen.
Yeah, with Toto and Yuji.
With Gojo.
Gojo. That was.
And even that one was sick. The Toto one was insanely cold.
Hey.
Clap down here. There were so
many. That's how your
many
mom sound last night.
Epic like fights. Ooh. And then another one. Another one I don't want to forget that, I was scrubbing a little bit.
Yeah,
Was one that I can't speak on too much because I haven't gotten to that point in the series. Is that Boruto?
Boruto's always got some good shit. Like
very epic fights.
They had the the cybernetics type people now, the ones that have implants and shit. And Naruto coming out, him and Kurama with their beast mode.
Yeah, so there's been a bunch of insane fights this year, but of course I got to go with that Asta
and Yami,
and my boy Yami.
Nice pick. I co-sign on that 100%. I think this is another category that we were stuck on too, was best opener, and I'm putting Crybaby from Tokyo Revengers. It just hits so good that it makes you want to put it in your playlist.
Yeah, there's no other song that I would want to hear this year starting up my wish tonight. One thing though, I want to say, the Shaman King intro isn't too bad.
No, Shaman King.
I found myself not being nostalgic. I wasn't skipping it. Yeah, I wasn't skipping it at all. I was just letting it ride
out. It's just nice and easy. It's a nice, easy one. It gets you hyped for it, and it follows the story, just like what's about to happen in the Shaman King battle. And
it did not get added to the playlist.
Hey, it's okay. Maybe not yet. Maybe not yet. Maybe you need to see a little bit more from Yo and Amidamaru. Maybe Ryu. You know, there needs to be an opening that leads into the final battle. I think that opening right there will clinch your nuts a little bit.
I'm not going to knock it, but so far.
My best closer for this year comes from the epic, like, fucking Day After Tomorrow, which is based off a manga called All I Need Is Kill. That was the actual book that inspired the film with Tom Cruise and Emily Blunt in it. Is 86, the second closer, which was Alchemia, and it just is so dreary in tone, so fucking somber that you're like, you can feel and understand what is wrong with this world. Like, and again, it's a world of segregation. These people that are in the 86, they pilot the droids that are going out into battle, which are being commanded by royals or white hairs in the capital city. And they're not supposed to be seen as human, but let alone one soldier who commands a unit. She cares for her team and she speaks to them like they're human, even though they're taught that they're not. So it's almost like the Hunger Games meets fucking The Day After Tomorrow. But the music fits the actual theme of the show. And it's very, very nice. I like it.
Nice.
What do you pick for best closer?
The only one, and this is kind of like a cheat just because it's the only one that's sticking out in my head right now.
Yeah.
While I was kind of going through different, those fight scenes.
Yeah.
Boruto had one that wasn't too shabby.
Son of Naruto. Like that classic type mixed with like a new hip hopish feel.
It was a very classic, like classical style.
I feel like Boruto does some kind of like JoJo's type shit in their opening and closer. So I have enjoyed them because they're very vibrant and just very, very popish. Like,
now, hey, I will say
it's the youth.
One of the coldest closers of all time, which I was just put on to this year, was that season of Joestar when they did what did they do, Jodeci?
Yeah. Yeah, they got like Walk Like an Egyptian. There's so many different iconic themes that are tied to this series. Like, yeah.
I mean, they did like not even just like a typical, I mean, there, I don't think there's no typical Jodeci songs, but they did like was it I Wanna Freak You?
Let me pull it up.
I'll pull it up. Let me pull it up real quick. Let me pull up on this screen so that way when I play it that the audience can hear what
what they're talking about in this song. Yeah, they're very good though because they want to tie in, you know, pop culture and then also that theme of JoJo. It has its own life to it. Like I said, you tune in.
Yeah, freaking you. That's what it was. Here it is. Yeah.
Put it up.
Every time I close my eyes. Can you hear it?
Oh yeah, I can hear it. Holy, I can't get you out of my mind.
I would give anything. and I was just like, what?
This is JoJo.
Like, ain't no way. I was like, ain't no way.
Oh yeah, they're doing.
I was like, ain't no way.
Baby. What you doing over there,
JoJo's
Dan?
Part five. Yeah.
Like I told you, JoJo steps out on the limb. Like they step out in their way. Like Junji Ito steps out and be listening to like the Beach Boys and shit when he making like his fucking masterpieces. But okay, I get down with that. I'll go with that. That's a good ass pick. Let's keep it pushing. Best narrative for this year. This one was tough. Just looking at all the different types that we had from our isekais. We had a lot of isekais this year. We have a lot of slice of life type shit, and then we have just a heavy hitting, you know, pack of action anime that have been here for a while, like My Hero Academia, Boruto, and then JoJo's Bizarre Adventure and titles like that. But the best narrative goes to one of the newcomers for me this year is Tactop Destiny, which really puts in perspective classical music or music of any type, because they do some swing, some jazz, classical, but it's based off of piano and how music can change the world. And I felt like building a story said there was a light that brought about peace, but then there was a light that was darkness, and now the world is post-apocalyptic, and the one thing that gave people joy, which was music, can no longer be used except for by professionals to battle and fight the abominations that came from the sky with that second darkness. What are you doing, Chewy? My dog's over here freaking out. He's like laying on the cover and like inching himself
like,
over
Jodeci
and shit.
Yeah, he's like, where the Jodeci at? Yeah,
he don't
Daddy,
need none
where
of that.
The Jodeci?
Hey, just
Daddy,
imagine that playing.
Pop away right now, Daddy.
Imagine that playing in a dog's head when he's about to bite a mailman's butt.
Hold on, take my camera.
You did just freeze like this. You're like, he's straight up on there.
Got that meme mug going on.
Hey, that's okay though.
Let me plug in my external battery.
No, you're good, but I'll keep going. Tactop Destiny was mine. It was just masterfully done because I didn't feel like the first episode would have been that good, and then the episodes after it continue to pull you in, and then you're like, what the fuck's going on? How are they going to come back from this? And I'm not going to lie, like we have been looking through things to watch because we were talking about Spider-Man here, and HBO Max has come back with Sex and the City. It's like... And just like that, Sex and the City came back, and they had some two major changes in the series, and it doesn't take away from the series, but it adds. But at first, you're like, oh, that's like a cop out, and then you're like, oh shit, they had to fucking do this to push the narrative forward. And I'm down with it. This shit looks good. And Tactop Destiny did something that was different that did pull at the heartstrings, but made you think like you know, you have a person that you know, but now you have a totally different person, and it's inside the body of somebody that you do know. How is this shit gonna work? And yeah, you know, with somebody in a berserker type state or a state that's going to like be self-destructive, how can they, you know, fulfill their dream? How can they save people? How is this going to affect their partner? So the narrative influences they take from multiple genres really kept me engaged in this brand new series, and this is why I give it best narrative for 2021.
Nice. I think on anime, I think I may have said my homies at Tokyo Revengers.
Mm-hmm.
But then another anime that I remember watching that just had me just like, wow, this is like, I have no idea where this story is even
fucking
headed.
Going.
And it was just nice as, what was it called? To Your Eterna.
Oh, right? To Your Eternity? Hell yeah. That one makes you, like, that first episode, you're like, I'm not crying.
I'm like, damn. Yeah, and what I liked about the anime is that it's not like a dark, dark anime, but there's a lot of, like, you're really getting, it's like an empathetic level of getting to know these characters.
Mm-hmm. And understanding, like, struggles through life. Like
real struggles. Like, yeah, the struggles of life and just how, you know, humanity continues to survive. I think it had like a really solid narrative.
Mm-hmm. The way that they presented it to people was very smart as well, because grief is something that triggers a lot of people and something that can be done very well or done very poorly. And like you said, they did it really, really well to where it's not like this person's going to die. And you know people are going to die, but it's like, what story are they telling before they pass, because that's where you're connecting with these characters. You're like, fuck, dude, they really have to,
and that's what made it so sick, was that these stories that they were able to you know, connect with was just insane. So I think I'm actually gonna pick that one just to diversify my portfolio.
Ooh, okay, I like that. I like that.
I'm gonna pick that one. But of course, right. You know, Tokyo Revengers.
Hey, Tokyo Revengers has got that shit on lock. You're like, where the fuck is this story going? Let's see. Next on the list, the next category that we have is, and we're saving best manga and anime of the year for the very end. We're going to best animation. yeah. We're going to best animation. And for me, overall, I've got to say everything that One Piece has been doing since the beginning of this year up until now, especially like in the land of Wano, there's been so many different style and artistic decisions that it surpassed everything else for me. And like Tacked Up Destiny, it surpassed fucking... you know, just like subtle things. Even Girlfriend had a lot of very small details within like the school slice of life that you don't normally see them focus on. But yeah, I think they had the best animation, because I sent you the clip of like Odin running and like slicing the giant boar in half. Odin versus Whitebeard. Yeah, that shit was clean.
That shit looked phenomenal. Especially I ended up watching, even while I was watching the fight. The fights, when I was looking at the best fight scenes,
Luffy
don't
level.
Look like Luffy from the hood no more.
Nah, he grown up a little
Luffy
bit.
Luffy don't like that same Luffy that I remember rocking with back in the old school days. I think I'm probably gonna have to keep mine the same. I think I had picked Black Clover.
Okay, because that shit was on point too. Not gonna lie,
They done dropped their whole budget on their, you know, animation skills. And you can see it. That's the dope part about it. You can truly see it, and it looks phenomenal.
Even though they had to stop the series early, they did not drop production value whatsoever in these last couple of episodes. So that one's a good one. Black Clover did, and especially coming back with Asta, like, all yoked up. And that motherfucker doing that Chucky run. That's like any time that somebody's running fast, that's like Chucky. Because Chucky used to run around people's houses and they turn around like, who the fuck is that? These little baby ass footsteps running. Like, that's Asta. That's Asta coming for your ass with all them swords. Okay, so next category, best protagonist. And I'm going to keep it real. Like, a lot of people hate him, but you got to love him because he's you.
I love
Takamichi from Tokyo Revengers. He is a true hero. He is trying to do everything he can.
That's the homie.
He is. Hey. Like, so many people are on his shoulders, sitting on his shoulders. Tell him.
The thing is about my boy Takamichi, compared to all the I don't believe anybody goes through the true hardship that my boy Takamichi goes through. Because other people, Goku, Asta, Luffy,
Gon,
they all went through some shit that fucked them up.
Yeah.
But they were so happy to get stronger.
Yeah.
Physically stronger.
Yeah, like actually.
Trying to get more magic. And then defeat the problem.
Yeah.
My boy Takamichi. Can't get a W to save his damn life.
Nah, not at all. He sees him all around him. But him himself.
All around him.
It's like trying to catch a fly in the air. He just can't do it.
Can't get it.
Takamichi.
And he still ain't got no hands. He ain't got no hands. And we're in the manga.
No.
Chapter 2. 37, 238.
He
still
hands,
ain't got no hands.
He got hands in the Valhalla battle, and they ain't changed since then. They're beginner hands.
Yeah.
Training wheel
hands.
That's
where he said, though. He said I'm the beginner hands for a long time. And the cool thing about the reason why I got a hardcore co-sign with you on Takamichi is because the fact, without spoiling anything, there's been times that he goes in the future where things seem okay.
Yeah.
And only like small things be off. But that enough just makes him want to go back. Where the average person be like,
okay, it's good enough.
It don't look too bad here. Let me just, hey guys, we're just going to rock out. This is what it is.
This is going to be the best version of the future we got.
Yeah, hands down.
Okay, yeah. Takemichi, again, if you guys have not read the manga, dip into it because it covers a fucking lot. And just like we have our best protagonist with Takemichi actually displaying the skills of a protagonist trying to continue to do the right thing without having that any power-ups, almost like old boy in Gate, who was just an otaku who just wanted to fund his obsession by going to work, and then this portal to another like medieval world kind of leads in. And because of his intelligence, he gets put on this job, and he's like, man, I just want to work enough to so I can go to conventions. We have best antagonists, and mine kind of follows the same suit as before. Katrina Klaas, the class, I think is how you pronounce it. My next life as a villainess, all routes lead to doom. She is the personification.
I need to start that.
Of, oh, yeah. It's funny as fuck, dude, because it shows, like, I was playing outside one day, and then I fell and hit my head, and it's like, and then I remembered, and I think she died. I think everybody dies around the age, like, 30, 35, and I don't know if she was an herbivore or not. Is it herbivore woman? I think it's an herbivore man, and what are the girls called? I don't know. They're talking about, like, the women and men that are in their 30s that aren't married yet. I don't know if she's one of those, but she dies and then is brought back in this video game world that she's played many a times. And she knows that Katrina's, her history shows that there's only two ways that she could end her life. One being exiled from the kingdom. That's the best version. And the worst version is dying. And so now she is trying to live her life, knowing all the moves she must make as a villainess to win the hero and have her best life ever by getting married and living a happy life. That's what every villain wants. They want to achieve their goals. She does it from episode one. There's two seasons of this. Katrina is going to be my best antagonist for the year of 2021.
So does she just constantly just try to rain on the protagonist of the episode? Is that what?
No,
that what
she's trying to.
Like what did she do that just had you like, yeah, that's a bad bitch?
No, she's just trying to, like, as a villain, like, why do not I not have this life? Oh, my power is that I know the future. Well, if I know that I'm going to have a shit life, I want to have the best version of my life. So where Little Red Riding Hood gets the apple, bitch, I was here first. I got the apple. So now my life should be better. Okay. But when she does it, her life kind of has unexpected turns to try to keep her in the lane of the villain. And then there's other people brought in, other girls that are brought in that could be love interests, other accidents and incidents that happen that could turn the way that people perceive her. So it's like she's Pete and Goof Troop. You know, like, he's not really a bad guy, but yeah. So that's close where enough. She is. Exactly.
Okay, okay. I think on the anime episode that we did last Wednesday, I chose my boy Mikey. Mikey from Tokyo Revengers, because he's involved in darkness in a way where
he's
wrapped up. But I had to change it.
I saw
someone pop up on the scene, and I was like, God damn, my boy, you don't give two F's, do you? I hope I pronounced the first name right, because they just call him Hal on the whole damn show.
Mm-hmm.
Shaman King.
Yeah, the other half, Yo's counterpart twin.
Yo, yeah, it's Yo's older brother, come to find out.
In the original, it was his ancestor.
And granted, that's how he is now. So he's his ancestor like 1,000 years ago, but he has been reincarnating himself.
In the body.
And now he's reincarnated. Yeah. And that dude just don't care. And his swag is so cold with it, too. I had a really, like, this particular part. And Shaman King, I think on the first part on Netflix, you see him like at the very beginning, like as an infant, you know, just being reincarnated and everybody freaking out. Then you see him at like the very last episode kind of showing his hands. On this one, they talk more about him.
Uh-huh.
They're actually, everybody's looking for this dude, trying to chase him, and they're actually having the big tournament, the Shaman King fight, the battles. Yeah. And just the way he fights and how many niggas want his ass. And how he don't hide.
Nah, he's like, I'm right here, bro. Come on.
Cheesing. I mean, you can tell he's so many.
Comfortable.
I had to write this through the pad. I was like, hey, dog, you be seeing a letter certified in the mail coming up the next, you know, few days. Please just sign it off.
Mm-hmm.
And that's your pass for the top shelf drinks, my man. Hey. That's your pass. Yeah, yeah. I had to get him a seat at the round table, dog.
Yeah, he's the one.
How is on a... And he just, yeah, he's cocky about it, but just so smooth about it. It's like he's a mixture of Escanor without as much
pride. He's prideful, pride. But he knows
he don't constantly talk about it.
Yeah. Again, like yeah. those, it's like the same thing that you guys saw in Yu-Gi-Oh. Like anybody coming, like Yami Yugi. He didn't really talk shit. Yeah, like Yami Yugi didn't talk shit. Yami's like, let's leave it in the heart of the cards. That's all I'm gonna tell you. I got enough experience to know what happens in these battles. Let's leave it to the heart of the cards, boy. I ain't got shit to say to you. Let's keep it pushing. Best opening. Now we did best opener music and best ending music. Now best opening and ending is like what brings out the entire feel of that arc. Yeah, like does the opening match the series arc that it's covering or this year? Because some arcs we know of are a year-long arc and it's like a full 24 episode slate. Some are 12 episodes and you have a season change. But does the latest opening display any attributes or display any scenes that will really pull you in to the season if it's something that you're not watching? And does it fit the description like when you're watching it? Because I know Black Clover came out with several like opening 10.
Black Clover.
They changed the theme. Yeah, dude. They did some nice ones.
Every new chapter, they rewrite the whole damn thing and put enough sprinkles of the story in there just to keep you hooked and like, ooh, who's that? Oh, what's that? Dude,
they really did. I didn't see anybody do as much. Oh, yeah. Do as much as them. It was like, hey, this arc changed within the next two episodes, so here's your new opening. Like, two episodes and we got a new opening? Oh, shit. Okay, so they about to fight this boy. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. They flip the marks like pancakes.
So that's who you going with, Black Clover?
Yeah, I'm going Black Clover.
I'm going One Piece again, opening 23, Dreaming On. Like that one right there, showing Luffy and the crew doing their raid of Onigashima and trying to save the capital, the flower capital and shit. It is really nice because you get to see everybody getting into this big-ass war. So you have Kaido Pirates, Big Mom Pirates versus the Straw Hats and Law Pirates, and also Eustace Kids and the Kid Pirates. So that's going to be my best opener. I'll do this one, best ending for this year. I'm not going to lie. The best ending for me, I know I had one. Which one do I have for anime? I can't remember what I have for anime, but I'm going to give it to JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, Stone Ocean. Going back and just watching that ending really summed up this series, the first part of this series, so well that I'm like, dude, it had me considering it just came out. And we're still within 2021. I'm like, man, is this going to be like within the best of anything right now? Because they have so many they have so many different things in there that keeps me picking it. But best ending that really encapsulate everything that has happened in the series is going to be JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, Stone Ocean with Jolene Kujo. What about you? What's your best ending?
I'll have to go with the Baki. Even though a huge fan, because that popped up when I was watching the different fight scenes, of course. And even though I wasn't a fan of this past season's Baki, just because of how they told the story.
And they changed something,
They changed some big things to me, which is still dope. I'm going to twist it. I'm just nitpicking. But the ending was good, man. That Baki ending is classic, man.
Dude, Baki, I think that was best animation for me last time was Baki because they're very specific about how they do stuff and I had to change it. Baki, these openings and endings have caught me by surprise. They're a little bit different than what I thought they would be going into this series after reading the manga. And then my buddy John, I went over to his house yesterday and he said he started and I was like, boy, when you get into it now, because he's big history buff. Again, you know John is crazy John. He's ex-military, but you know, he wrote the book on combatives for the Navy SEALs that they've been using. He was with them for, I can't say how many years, for an enormous amount of years. And we were talking about Baki, and I was like, wait until you get to when they bring back Miyamoto Musashi. And he's like, the Sword Saint? And he's like, they bring in like realistic aspects into this. And that's one of the things I love about the manga that gets translated into the show is the appreciation and the explanation of the martial arts, being a martial artist myself. But let's keep it pushing. We got four more categories. These are the last four. Best overall score, best couple, best manga of the year. So it'd just be manga of the year and then anime of the year. For me, best score overall is going to be Tacked Up Destiny. Again, the way that they use music to illustrate the story, emotions, how things drive forward. The other one that I would give honorable mention to is Cowboy Bebop having a Western-style soundtrack that plays in the background for everything that's going on to drive that narrative story. But yeah, Attack Top Destiny for me. What about you, Buck?
I'll have to go with Tokyo Booty Avengers. Buck
cheeks. Tokyo Revengers. Tokyo Revengers, like just that fight music. It always reminds you of Dragon Ball Z.
The pacing, how, you know, like when people died in it, it like, you like, ooh, shit. Like, damn.
It's serious. Things matter. Dark anime.
I thought this was like little kids and shit. Like, damn.
Not these middle school and high schoolers.
No, hey, we see them getting beat up and the faces all knotted up. And sometimes it's jokingly, but sometimes like, y'all just got done putting in work again?
Hey, damn. Them hands is working mighty fast.
Damn. You know, when you see Mikey's brother, you know, get dot, you know, damn, get dealt with, yeah, by with his that pipe. Best friend, you just be like, oh, shit.
And that's what y'all be. I will say, like, when they do hits like that, the sound is like kind of gut wrenching, kind of like nasty. Shit.
Ouch.
Oh, no.
Funky Breath ain't about to revive you after that.
Hey, it might. I don't know. I feel like it breath might, that strong.
Some breath can.
Dude, that's just. I can't even talk about it right now. I'm having flashbacks over here. Let's next category, best couple. And this could be however you want to see it. Hmm. I did a combo. I'm doing the generals. I'm doing the commanders. I'm doing the lieutenants of the Straw Hat Pirates. Roar, Nora, Zolo, which if you guys are reading the manga, they went back to putting Zolo in there instead of Zoro, which was his original first name before, you know, the lawsuits and shit like that. And Sanji, and don't say the Vin Smoke, are my couple right now in Onigashima, and the battles they're having with King and Queen, fucking legendary. But the shit that they have been doing in this season of Wano, as they run around individually as Soba Mask or just Zorodona, they have gone around, they've come together in moments of high emotional stakes and proved why they're, you know, Luffy's right and left hand man. So I'm gonna give it to them. Zolo and Sanji are my best couple for 2021. What about you, sir? It's too late.
Yeah, I'm not too sure on that, man. I'm trying to think of a duo. I can't think of one. I really can't. Without just off the top of my head, I can't.
I'm
gonna have to. I'll do this. I'll get a picture of when I do think of it, and I'll post it on the Elijah Bailey Show Instagram page.
You can do that. I was in that Tokyo Avenger world. I was like, oh, you wasn't gonna give Baji-kun and Chihai. You wasn't gonna give them. They eating food together.
They eating food together, but they had a lot of issues that I wasn't really too fond of. Okay.
He Batmaned it. He Batmaned it too early in the series, because he could have stayed alive. Gotcha.
And I could say, you know, even just Draken and Mikey, but nah, I just don't feel right. I don't know. I got to think about that one.
Okay.
I didn't realize that was even.
Yeah, that one was on the tail end.
Yeah.
Okay, so think about it and post it on the pages, which if you guys want to follow us on social media, which I know you do, follow us social media. We have the Elijah Bailey Show, Chop Off the W on the N on Twitter. You can follow us on our Facebook page. You can follow Discord, which Discord was put in the chat if you're following on twitch.tv/_5000. And if you're not, go ahead and hit the heart button. Show us some love. Turn on subscription.
Tell us what you're at. Tell us
anime of the year. Yeah, for these categories. We've already answered all these categories except for two. So who is your best husbando, best waifu? What's your best fighting scene or the best opening and closing music, best narrative, best animation, best protagonist and antagonist, or best complete opening ending scene, best overall score, best couple, and what is your anime and manga of the year? Let's go to manga of the year. I know we're going to agree on this. Tokyo Revengers. We've already talked about this. Sir. Hands down, manga of the year made us catch up on 235 chapters, 35. Right?
Is it 35?
It's either 25 or 35. I think we're in the 35s right now.
I think
we're 35.
We're in the 30s. Yeah.
Yeah, because we had that hiatus, that break, because we'd be going to 236 this week. But caught up on all those fucking chapters, Tokyo Revengers has been driving that narrative story where they keep restructuring. Because of time travel, what happens and why Takemichi has to save and go back in time and go forward. And right now I'm like, is he going to go forward in time and how and what we'll do? Because last time it kind of made it kind of definite that he couldn't do a goddamn thing from the future. Our boy Mikey with the black hair.
It's getting real. It's getting real. And
guns involved? Guns?
Okay.
Okay.
Design? I'll have to go with you just because, I mean, granted, you know, we are both insanely geeked on the 20th of every month to catch Super. We're super excited every Sunday to watch Black Clover. I think Slime drops on the 28th of every month.
Yes, it does.
I'm watching. But Tokyo Revengers had me just ready to drop everything while I was in Hawaii just to binge these manga chapters. My wife looked at me and was like,
what are you doing?
My boy, you doing cracking there? I was like, I can't help it. This is pure Colombian. Bam, bam.
Yeah. Tokyo. It's one of those that pulled me in like Siren did when I first read it. And the pages of Shonen Jump, I was like, oh, okay. You get taken to future Japan and you're in the present Japan. And this little fucking Hisoka type minstrel comes out. Okay, he's not trying to fuck the kids, so, or maybe he is in a different way, but I like it. I'll go to Siren, and this one just picked up. I'm like, hey, bro, I'm about to be caught up with you. How many days are going to take you? Give me two days to read. And it was one of those.
That's all it took.
Okay, let's hit that last question. What is your anime of the year then?
Last crucial question, which is tough. It's actually, believe it or not, It's tough for your boy. It's hard for everybody this year. It's tough for every year. Because, you know, we even got to think back, you know, Noblesse came out earlier this year.
Yes, it did.
I've been super excited on forever. Black Clover ended this year. Attack on Titan came out beginning this year. Which
I'm not going to lie. Attack on Titan had me feeling certain kind of ways.
Levi? You think Levi ain't about to show out? Guess what? He's about to show out.
Hell yeah.
But kind of as you guys been hearing, I'll just keep it plain and simple in black and white. Tokyo Revengers got my anime of the year.
Dude, and that's a good one to pick. It came out.
And then
out...
even my Gundam came out. Gundam Narrative movie, The Halfway Story. Yeah. I loved it.
Yeah.
I don't think we had anything bad to say.
You did?
I watched it again. Y'all watched it again this morning while I was taking a shower. I had it on and I was just like.
Ain't nothing. Sometimes there's nothing better than just like.
Animation,
hearing.
That is beautiful. Ooh, like
beautiful the sound dude. Especially for like even the small like doors opening, small shit like that, you're like, I am here in this fucking world. And
you could tell this is a movie.
Yeah, because like this, the whole hotel scene and shit, like it was kind of weird. I'm like, you just gonna let her do what she want, bro? Like, this is what you're gonna do? And then you're like, oh, okay, I understand what you're doing. Okay. And even Dr. Stone this year, like the Stone Wars and shit, My Hero Academia, like you said, Shaman King. Even Burning Comedy. I like Burning Comedy because it taught me what the fuck comedy was. What else do we have this year?
It's been a great year. I mean, didn't Fire Force come out this year?
I think that the last half of it did, yeah. I'm pretty sure it did. How Not to Summon a Demon Lord, Omega came out, which was good. I've been killing slime for 300 years and maxed out my level. The World's End with You, like we talked about, 86, Eden Zero. There was just a lot of shit that came out. Even, was it this year or was that last year? Blood of Zeus and shit like that for Netflix.
Oh, that did come out this year.
Yeah. Like, you know what? Let me verify that, Blood of Zeus. You looking it up?
Yeah, I got it. Right,
yeah, there. Let me know because I might change my pick. Because Fena Pirate Princess was one that captured me because the artwork was so goddamn beautiful.
It has 2020.
Okay,
badge
good.
On it.
Fena Pirate Princess. Oh, okay. So yeah, that's why I felt like early this year because it's October. Just like some things are just so visually stunning. You guys know how I feel about Lupin. Lupin had part 6 come out, and that shit, like, part 5 was fucking beautiful and genius, so was part 4. What's mine? That's what I'm getting to. I feel like mine is going to be... I feel like I don't want to say Tokyo Revengers because where it stopped doesn't really encapsulate that first season to me. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, it doesn't encapsulate that first half for me. Even though it's done beautifully, I'm going to go with the wild card here. I'm going to say Record of Ragnarok, because that was something I was looking for a long time.
That was
from the
manga.
It was so good. Dude, despite what the fuck y'all say.
That was spicy. That was good. I'm super stoked. Boy, when you see your daddy, your forefather, the original great grandpappy.
Start shaking
Adam
around and shit.
The scene,
hey.
You're like, holy shit. He's fighting for humanity. What?
For my children. Like, oh, this is anime daddy. This is anime daddy. And then, you know, we had Jack the Ripper. You had fucking Poseidon. Thor. Oh, dude, there's so much. So many good things that I've only read in the manga. And I was happy to see it come alive. And it was something that was really done well, even though people are like, well, Aphrodite had her titties held by non-defined people. Are they a part of the LGBTQ community? Or like, we need to represent them. I'm like, dude, they're just they're titties. Yeah. They're just titties. That's what they are in real life. The good. Titties. What do they do?
There's
titties.
Good.
That should be the name of this episode. They're just titties, dude. It's like everybody's tripping over titties. Like, hey, I ain't putting my OnlyFans. Yeah, they're still just titties, though. I'm not paying for that. Like, no, ma'am. I'm not paying for that. Just like I'm not paying for extra ketchup packets at McDonald's just because you want to give me two for 45 fucking nuggets, bro. I will eat these dry bitches and be happy at home without your fucking ketchup packets I have to pay $1.25 for.
But, tell them.
Yeah, Record of Ragnarok. That's going to be the anime for the year for me. And go to my other podcast, A Little Bit of Anime, where me and the Bucky are both there. He is the voice of Anime God, and I am a co-host on that show, sitting across from Monica Robinson. And listen to our anime 2021 predictions, which differ a little bit from this award show.
Slightly.
I had to go back and check some things because it has been a heavy anime year for us. But let's do this. Let's take our last pause for the cause. We're going to come back with the anime and manga of the month, and then we will be done with today's episode. But thank you so much, everybody, that's been jumping in and joining in chat as we've been talking about our picks for all 15 categories for anime of the year. And remember, Buck will put his post for best couple up on the pages when he gets it. But let's go ahead and take a pause for the cause as you listen to the Boruto theme where Naruto is fused with Kurama as we dive out on this commercial break. We'll be right back with episode 295 right after this. Ada, ada. Want to know if you've got potential? What I mean to say is, do you want to know if you've got what it takes to find love? With only 3 easy payments of 5,000 yen, that's exactly $45.54 USD, you too can afford the Max Pretty Love Detection Cannon. All you have to do is think of the person you love, and the device will automatically lock onto their location via the heart arrow targeting system, no matter where they are. Once you pull the trigger of love, the cannon will send an invisible strand to attach itself to your crush and start to send your light of love directly into them, awakening their love receptors, allowing them to open up to the idea of their love interest. Get yours while they last.
Providing bankruptcy services throughout the state of Oklahoma, Bowler & Associates is a bankruptcy law firm based in Midwest City, Oklahoma. Their mission is to relieve you from threat of debt collectors, garnishments, repossessions, tax levies, foreclosures, and much more. Backed by more than 20 years of experience in the legal field, they excel in finding the quickest, most effective, and most affordable solution to all your legal and financial troubles. You can find them at Bowler Law on Facebook and also visit their website at www.bowlerlawfirm.com. Reach them at 405-733-3000. You can also email them at bankruptcy@bowlerandassociates.com.
Folks, we are back to the show to round out the end of the show. Normally I have the video playing because we're doing anime and manga of the month, but this time you can listen instead of watch. We have anime of the month, Sakugan. It's a Japanese anime television series produced by Satelight and directed and written by Junichi Wado, with character design by Yuji Awahara and music by Tatsuya Kato, which premiered October 2021. One day in the distant future, humans live shoulder to shoulder in colonies separated by rock. And then outside these colonies, a dangerous undeveloped area called the Labyrinth is expanding. Those who risk their lives to develop the Labyrinth, who mark out undeveloped areas, are known as markers. A young girl named Mimi Poo, who wants to be a marker one day, and a man named Gagumbar, who used to be one, this mismatched father and daughter now take on the Labyrinth. If there's no path, dig one. 8 episodes, which actually I think it's 10 episodes now, 10 or 11, which is on Crunchyroll VRV. Mimi Poo, her mom named Linda, is a marker, and she is a marker duo with her dad. Once,
family ties.
Yeah. Mimi Poo wants to follow in her mother's footstep, but her mom, Linda, and her dad, Gagumbar, got a divorce, and Gagumbar wants his daughter to be safe. No longer being a marker himself, he just wants her to live a nice, safe life. And her being like Senku, super smart, she wants to use more of her abilities and find her own way in the world. This is a nice little anime where you get to discover like the underworld of Gurren Lagann, because that's what I put it akin to. The next one, manga of the month, Tokyo Shinobi Squad, story by Yuki Tanaka and art by Kento Matsura. In the future, a lawless Tokyo, retribution is delivered by Shinobi. So Tokyo 2049, thanks to the Galapagos reform enacted by the government, Russia, China, America, and Japan are now connected by a hyperloop system. This globalization has turned Tokyo into the most crime-ridden city in the world. To fight the rising crime, those who have been working in the shadows since the Sengoku period are needed. They are shinobi, and we follow our shinobi, Jin, who is known for being this badass magnetic shinobi. But he does not follow the normal rules of shinobi society. So what I mean is, if you watch One Punch Man, how they have the Heroes Association, they have a shinobi association, but Jin only takes on cases that actually help mankind. He doesn't just do it for the money. He doesn't take those S and A rank missions like Naruto would. He takes the one that he thinks him and his Tokyo Shinobi Squad should be doing to better the future. This is one that you can read. I'm only 3 to 4 chapters in Tokyo Shinobi Squad.
How many chapters is it?
Let me check and see. I think there's at least 30 before it's finished. It's a short read.
I know I'm ready to get on this long read, though.
Dude, it is long, 27 chapters.
Age read.
It's going to be good. You're going to like it. When you get in, you'll be like, Granola, what you doing over here? Granola, where'd you get them muscles at?
There ain't been one chapter that I didn't like.
That is true.
I just put it like that. There ain't been one chapter of this show that I have not enjoyed.
Dude, I'm right there with you. This shit has been unfolding. So many secrets, so many treasures that we've been getting as we've been reading Dragon Ball Super. But 27 episodes, or 27 chapters for Tokyo Shinobi Squad. 10 episodes out for Sakugan, which you can find on Crunchyroll and VRV. That rounds out anime and manga of the month for you guys that you can watch and read in the month of December. The happy holiday month, if you will. The Christmas month. The Hanukkah month. The whatever holiday month you have. The no job, get your ass out of here month. Whatever it is. You hit that Listerine 2, 3, 4, 5 times back to back. Playboy month. You know, maybe you should just suck on peppermints all the time.
Suck on peppermints, boy. Or maybe just take your ass to the dentist.
Hey, if you eating ass,
you got to stuff it, man. It needs to be clean.
Hey, if you eating ass, put some sugar and peppermints on that shit, buddy. Just help yourself out, you know? Don't, like, I'm just going to keep it natural. Like, yeah, there's nothing. Baking soda, will that work? We got some bleach. Let's get that shit. Need something for the breath. But thank you guys for tuning in. What was what's something that you're looking forward to in 2022 as far anime wise is coming out that you know of?
Overlord, super stoked about that. Rise of a Hero, super stoked about that.
Oh shit!
Of course, the Dragon Super movie. What's wrong?
I just got this. Like, I was asking you that something came out yesterday. Is the Black Clover mobile video game coming out for 2022, and it looks good.
Yes, it looks pretty good. Looks really good.
Damn.
But so going. Far, I think that's what I'm excited for. That's what I've heard of. Mm-hmm. So yeah.
Nice. How about you? You know, I'm always excited for the next version of Baki because, you know, it's got to keep going. There's more chapters than you guys know of for Baki. But the things I was talking about, Dragon Ball Super, Super Heroes coming out, I'm super excited to see Gohan back in action. And then they really did a good job of talking about why he hasn't taken off. Like, even though he has greater potential than Goku and Vegeta, he's just not a fighter at heart. We know that. He wanted to be a scholar. But now he's picking back up the fight, and we see that Pan is as well. So Dragon Ball Super Hero is something that I'm ready for and I'm ready to see. Also, I want to fucking watch the Christmas showdown for Tokyo Revengers and the Thousand Year Blood arc for Bleach. I've been super excited to see those. And Chainsaw Man, because I was like, if they animate this is going to be the most gruesome anime that's been out in years. Not the most gruesome ever, but that's been out in years, because their guts and entrails and shit flying around and getting rotated on chainsaws, head getting cut off, blood. There's all kinds of shit like that. So that's what I'm excited for. That's what I'm waiting for.
Granola whooping ass.
Oof. Boy. Granola whooping ass. But
I stopped by Popeyes before I came over here. That's how I got my strength back, and I brought you a two-piece.
Hey, he's like, hey, Gas, why don't you – these are biscuits. Go ahead and eat them because you're about to choke, bro. Thank you guys for tuning in. This has been episode 295. Sorry, we had some issues, some drop frame issues. I'm going to get on those today. Again, this is the first time I've been streaming since the modem's been taken out, but now we're back in action, and I will be back with another stream later tonight. I don't know. Fist of the North Star, Naruto, Fighters. There's a lot of shit that I'm excited to play. And, you know, the holidays are coming up. I'll have some time off. I'll get some extra days off. So I'll be streaming any new games I do pick up on those days. Anything that's coming your way. I can't say too much because the wife watches the show. You know, it's Edge Gaming. That's both our initials. And we got some gifts and shit coming. So prepare for that. But you enjoyed Spider-Man. I know I will. I already know too much. And I know that I'm going to enjoy it. All I can say is, like, did that come out of you? Like, yeah, bro. Yeah, it did. And it's going to go into your mom. Where can people find you and Blacken Studios and anything Blacken else that you're involved in?
Blacken Studios. No, just Blacken Studios.
He's just keeping it simple, folks.
It's just simple. You can see my name and pop up here and there at the _ Buckety.
Do you know... they got this new, I guess it's a TikTok. I didn't see it on TikTok. I saw it on YouTube Reels. And they're playing, God, what's the song? They're playing the song and people are like, doom, doom, doom. And they turn the camera to the side and shit. It was one, I just now thought about it. Yeah, it was like when you grow up, and this is white guys, like when you grow up and your parents are racist, and then he turned to the side, he had his wife is black.
Black family.
Yeah, and he had like five black kids. I was like, hell yeah. He's like, dum, 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 dum. We niggas over here. I can't say it still. Sorry. Sorry, honey. I can't say it, but that's what we are, mom. That's what we are, dad. Don't disown me.
That's what we are. Yeah. No, disown me. I does not care. Anymore. Look at this. I'm recording myself.
Because he's nasty. That's why, folks. Make sure to follow anything and everything about the Elijah Bailey Show on our official Facebook page, on our Twitter, Snapchat, at Elijah Bailey Show. Without the W, just chop the W off at the end. You can send emails to ElijahBaileyShow@gmail.com. Simply subscribe, rate, and review on Twitch, on Facebook, or on Apple Podcasts, or follow us on our hosting website, Podbeam, where you can see a lot of exclusive episodes I've done with Podbeam on their round tables and panels. And also exclusive content from our Patreon page, patreon.com/ElijahBaileyShow. Thank you guys for tuning in so much for the 2021 Anime Awards. And next week we have the Video Game Awards, which there's a lot of shit going on. And the Video Game Awards,
I say.
Yeah, we're going to have to. This one, I have to get
Except
on this.
Except why, I'm joining your club.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yes, I won't be there until like next, like, shipping looks ugly for me.
Okay, no, you're good.
I missed the boat.
Yeah, you should have got on it as soon as you talked to me. Like,
I missed the boat.
Did you go where I went? You went where I went, and they was like, we ain't got
it. They're the only ones who had it. Yeah, Best Buy, Target, they didn't have it.
It was like,
lucky Wally World, they was like, hey, you trying it now? You gotta wait though.
Hey, like, where's
how much I gotta wait for this? Like, you might get lucky if it's before this year.
Tomorrow.
Yeah, they're talking about January 3rd for my delivery.
That ain't too bad, but still, you're like,
nah,
fuck, bro.
Like
right now, I'm in the age of technology, so fuck everything else. Like, I want, like, over here, this bad boy right here, that's Jarvis. The next one coming in,
hey, Jarvis.
That's Edith. Edith. Wasn't her name?
Have you ever watched anime called I think it's called Eden of the West?
I have not watched it, but I know what you're talking about.
You should check that out. And I think after you watch that, you will rename one of your
consoles.
I think you will.
Okay.
Eden of the East. That's what it's called.
Eden of the East. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
It's super short. You can watch it on. It might be on Crunchy, I'm not sure. And it's only 11 episodes. You can bang through that.
Yeah, that's easy, dude. Yeah. I've been like I said, I got through 4 seasons of Saint Seiya in a few days trying to watch it before it left Netflix, all 6 seasons. So, yeah, I can get through that. And then Joestars, I watched that in like 2. So, you good. But
yeah.
Make sure to follow us. Make sure to turn on notifications for all the new followers. The schedule is coming back into effect again. We're here to stream. I am here to stream. I got a lot of fucking video games I want to play. A lot more coming in. It is time to do the things that we enjoy. Do the things that we love, and we do them right here on this channel. Don't worry about the reception. Don't worry about that shit. We'll be handled and taken care of. I am one of your hosts, Elijah 5000.
And I am the underscore
buddy. Yeah,
it's always been a pleasure coming through. It's
always a
pleasure coming
through. Make you do your own work.
I tell you. Always, especially on the fun episodes.
It's inside of you. It's always inside of you, folks. Anime's inside you. We're inside of you. In your hearts. In your ears. Thank you for joining the show, and we will catch your ass in the next podcast. We're out. See you.
Bang. Here we go. Give me a little bit of cowboy.
What's up, everybody? Elijah 5000 here. Me and the Buckety appreciate it so much that you download this show each and every week. Again, we drop every Thursday. If you're new to the Elijah Bailey Show, go to Apple Podcasts, Podbeam, or Spotify, or wherever you listen to this auditorial pleasure that you get weekly, and just subscribe, rate, and review. Thank you, and I'll catch your ass in the next podcast.